Dear friends, I had to share this message because I love you all the most. All right, so if you are tuning in or getting this share, this is a very important message and share for those going through the holidays or any time of the year when you or a loved one is working really hard to break free from an addiction. And so this is an excerpt from my new best-selling book, Bootstraps and Bra Straps, the formula to go from rock bottom back into action in any situation. And it's a serious discussion with some guidance on how to break free from addictions. And to get the entire book, you may go to www.sheilamac.com, and it is also available on Amazon, Kindle, and Audible. We also have a course, a small group support groups, courses that I run with people that are seeking to break free from addictions. So check out the site online to learn more. And here we go. Take a listen.
The cycle, addiction. Maggie grew up loved by her relatives and friends. Shortly after coming into this world, she was adopted. Her birth mother had addiction problems and got pregnant very young. Close relatives arranged Maggie's adoption by two loving parents who couldn't have children of their own. Maggie grew up in a beautiful environment. She was well cared for, went to top schools, and had private tutoring when she needed it. She loved horseback riding, ice skating, and hours spent with her parents. They loved Maggie and gave her everything they possibly could. Then, toward the end of high school, Maggie's dad got sick and died. Maggie had received a full scholarship to college, but she deferred admission for a year so she could stay home and help her mom through the grieving process. She didn't feel like she could leave until her mom was settled and in a healthy place. Financially, they had to adjust. They sold the house Maggie had grown up in and moved to a smaller one across town. She finished high school, but one by one, her friends left for college and Maggie stayed at home. In high school, Maggie hung out with friends and had a beer or smoked a little pot, or whatever kids do that we don't want them to do. As her friends went away to college and she grieved her father's death in her own way, she began hanging with a new crowd and experimenting with harder drugs. Maggie's mother was going through her grieving process, so she wasn't quite as present as she'd been in the past. She missed the signs that Maggie was slipping into addiction. If she had thought about it, she probably would have believed she knew and trusted her daughter. Experimenting with hard drugs wasn't a behavior she would suspect from the child she knew. While Maggie hung out with her friends, Maggie's mom went to grief counseling. By the time she noticed the changes in Maggie's behavior, the situation was severe. Maggie wasn't working. She wasn't doing anything. She stole money from her mom and friends. When her old high school friends came back to visit from college, they wondered what happened and who this new person was. It was very painful for those friends to see this young woman they loved so much go down such a difficult, terrible road. She lost a lot of friends who didn't want to hang out with somebody doing that to themselves. Maggie didn't get to go to college the next year. She lost her scholarship. Now her mom had to go through a new grieving process, losing the version of the little girl she thought she knew. Filling a void. People aren't born smokers or alcoholics, but they may be at risk for addiction. Maggie's birth mother was an addict. It's possible that Maggie inherited an increased likelihood of addictive behavior. Beyond that risk, however, Maggie was also trying to fill a void. Many times, people try to kill the pain of grief or loss with drugs, alcohol, cigarettes, or eating disorders. People who exhibit addictive behaviors are filling something in their life that they don't feel empowered about, that they feel they don't have control over. So they go down that road as an escape route. They can't deal with it, so they go drink or smoke pot. Sometimes it's only a couple of drinks or smoking a little for a brief period of time. Other times it's a slippery slope to higher level, hardcore drugs that can lead to an overdose. Whether it's lighter substances, even cigarettes, or hardcore drugs, when the substance controls you instead of you controlling your use, that's a sign of addiction. The things people are addicted to vary from one person to the next. Whether it's a drug, a food, alcohol, or an activity that's bad for you. People have sexual addictions, addictions to gambling or shopping. Unbalanced behavior without moderation is another sign of addiction. Whatever form it takes, addiction can lead straight to rock bottom. I don't believe addicts choose to be addicts. They want to escape or numb a painful situation and use the substance or activity to do so. What begins as perhaps an entertaining, one-off experiment triggers the feel-better part of their brain, and when things are bad again, they go do the behavior again to feel better, and it becomes a vicious, uncontrollable cycle. When a chemical is involved, it's not easy to control. If it were, addicts would be able to say, "Well, I'm done. I'm not going to do that anymore." If you can't control your behavior, it's an addiction. Whether you see that in yourself or in a loved one, you need support and a community. So you don't have to go through that alone. It's going to take a lot of willpower and other resources to get through. You may want to help the loved one who has an addiction with all your heart, but you're going to have to do more than just talk about it. What to do if you recognize addiction in yourself? If you're reading this book and going through an addiction yourself, struggling to pull away and wanting to live the life you envisioned, but your addiction continues to pull you back down, know that for your children, for yourself, for the life that you desire, you're going to have to put down that addiction. If you don't, we have an activity at the end of this chapter that shows how your addiction affects every single aspect of your life. If your addiction is controlling you and you're not in control of your life, you need to consider seeking medical treatment for an addiction. If you recognize addictive behavior in yourself, maybe this just solidifies it, or maybe it brings it to light for you. You thought things were going fine, and then you realize, oh, that's why my family isn't speaking to me. Or that's why I'm having such a tough time at work and always getting in trouble. I recently met a 32-year-old waiter who works two jobs but is still struggling to pay his rent because he goes out drinking most nights of the week. All his friends drink, his family drinks, and that's the only way he knows how to socialize. Anything he does outside of work involves alcohol, and it's starting to mess up his life. He's tired all the time, he doesn't feel well most days, and he wants to find one well-paying job instead of working two lower-paying ones. As we talked, he finally admitted, "I think I have a problem with my drinking." If you've had a similar realization, you may be wondering what you should do or what you can do. You have to address the real cause of what led you down that road, honor your experience, and face it, then deal with whatever you have to do to get rid of some of it. That may require medical intervention, medication to get off the drug, or going through a rehab program because now your body is physically addicted to the substance. You may need to find a new peer group who are focused on the positive things you want to accomplish, like work, school, or personal development. You need to change your environment so that you set yourself up for success, removing the people, situations, or items that trigger your addiction. Then, you need to replace your addiction with a new, healthy behavior. What can you replace this coping mechanism with? Some people get a high when they run, and that allows them to process the things that are happening in their life. Or if running isn't where you're at right now, Maybe you want to try yoga to help you get calm and centered. There has to be something new that you pick up instead of picking up that drug or alcohol or credit card or food to binge on. If you used to be addicted to burgers and fries, maybe you can get addicted to going out dancing or doing yoga or riding your bike. You can replace an addiction to drinking or a drug with writing in your journal, blasting music, or painting when things are difficult. Maybe you're going to join an adult sports team. We don't have to stop playing just because we're adults. I have a client who used to be a competitive swimmer. That was her healthy release and way to cope. Then she had children and got stuck working long hours in a job she didn't like. She was doing everything for everyone else and nothing for herself. So to cheer herself, she would eat little treats. One day when her kids were in high school, she realized just how out of shape she was. Thinking back, she also realizes that she's been miserable for years. She's not happy, so she numbed her misery with food. She struggled with that realization. She was angry. She asked herself, "What the hell happened to me?" After dealing with her immediate reaction, she decided to take a plunge and make one change for herself. One of the neighbors let her use their pool in exchange for teaching their children how to swim. Soon she started teaching other children how to swim as well. Eventually, she started her own swimming school. Now she's in great shape and she still teaches swimming. Her kids are grown and she taught her grandkids how to swim. And she's happy. She needed a way to replace that addiction with something positive. Your healthy replacement doesn't have to be expensive. It doesn't have to please another human being. It's just something that is your way of expressing yourself or having fun that isn't eating or doing something else to fill the void. Then it's a real happiness, not a drug-induced feeling from an activity that drags you down. It's a healthy habit that leads to taking back that control in your life, rather than letting your addiction determine where you end up. What to do if you recognize addiction in a loved one? As I said, addiction affects everyone and everything in your life. But what does it look like for the person on the other side of that addiction? You may experience a child, friend, or partner struggle with an addiction, but you can't just tell them, "Oh, just stop drinking. Get addicted to the beach." That's a great idea, but when it's not your own idea, it won't work. And then you'll have the added resentment of, "Who the hell are you to tell me what to do?" Sometimes people say things they wouldn't say if they weren't in that addiction space. Their character and personality are almost lost. It's not them. They have something else that's ruling their common sense or right thinking. If they were in control, in their right mind, and not addicted to something, they would not want the addiction in their life, your life, or their children's lives. When somebody's ready to kick an addiction, they ask, "What can I do? What are my options?" They're ready to walk through that door instead of you having to push them. I know that you want to push them because you love them so much. You have the desire to push them, drag them, or do whatever you have to do, figuratively or literally, just to get them to that healthy place because you want the best for them. Sometimes that means stepping out of the picture.
All right, so that was a portion of a chapter from my new best-selling book, Bootstraps and Bra Straps, The Formula to Go from Rock Bottom Back into Action in Any Situation. Breaking Free from Addictions is the chapter. So I also have a special gift for you. Protect yourself and your loved ones from the controlling, manipulative difficulties of addiction. Learn how to defend against backsliding and help to reboot your addiction from one that controls you or a loved one to a healthy habit that blesses all. Get your 2-week email-based addiction defense course at www.sheilamack.com/defense. Now, this is a free course for you. It's a mini course. And then if you would like to join a small support group, that is also available at SheilaMack.com. And I hope this helps. All right, I'm sending you happiness and wellness blessings at its finest, and I'm giving you some homework. Grab a copy of my latest book, Bootstraps and Bra Straps, The Formula to Go from Rock Bottom Back into Action in Any Situation. That's right. If life has knocked you down, get ready to pick yourself back up and give